Hello everyone, how are you all? I would like to welcome all of you to Mother English School. I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. As you all know, my dear students, that this is the class of Standard 1. Right now we are learning subject Maths. Let's begin our journey with a very beautiful thought. Thought for the day is, those who don't want to change, let them sleep. Those who don't want to change, let them sleep, said by Rumi. What does it mean by the person, the people who don't want to change their life or lifestyle as per time requirement, let them stop where they are right now and move on. Okay, as we are doing that, this is the requirement of this critical situation that we have to start our study with the help of online education, and we are doing that. And the person who don't wants to move on, who just wants to stay in their lifestyle only, they don't wants to break their who don't wants to break their comfort zone, let them stay where they are and you move on. Yes, we are there with you, my dear students. Okay, so let's begin our class. What are the learning objectives for today? Today we are going to make revision of chapter 2. In this chapter 2, we will learn double digit addition and problem sums or story sums. We also make revision of table number 1, 2 and 3. What happens when you add 10 to a number? What happens when you add 10 to a number? Let me tell you, the ones digit remains the same when you add 10. The ones digit remains the same when you add 10. The tens digit increases by 1 every time you add 10. Let's see how it happens. What happens when we add 10 to a number? What happens when we add 10 to a number? Let's see in the picture. This is the building of 10 blocks. We have the number 10. And what we have to do? We have to add some more numbers to it. Let's see how we can do it. 10 plus 1, 2, 3, and 4. We have to add 4 more to number 10. Look, by adding 4, what will happen? As I told you ever and ever, that whenever you are going to start addition, you have to start just after the given number. 10 after 11, 12, 13 and 14. We get the number 14. Okay? Understand, my dear? Let's see with some more examples, huh? Look, this is the building of 10 blocks. Now, how many numbers should we add more? 1 and 2. That means we have to add 2 more to 10. 10 plus 2. And what will be the sum of 10 plus 2? 10 after 11 and 12. Which number will we get, my dear? Yes, we get 12. Okay. Let's see some more examples. Look, this is the building of 10 blocks. And we have to add 1 more to it. 10 plus 1. 10 plus 1. At the end, what will we get? 10 and 1? 11. Understand? Okay. Look. Now, this is the building of 10 blocks. How many numbers should we add more? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We have to add 5 more to it. What will happen if we add 5 more to number 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now by adding this to number 10, 10 after 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. At the end, what will we get? We get number. Which number? What do you say? Yes, it is 15. See some more examples. This is the building of 10 blocks. And we are going to add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. By adding 7 to number 10, what will we get? 10 after 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. So, what do you say? What should I write in this box? Should I write 17? Yes. By adding 7 to number 10, we get number 17. Look, what is this? This is the blocks of 25 number. What is the sum? 25 plus 10. What should we do now? We have to add 10 more to 25. And for that, we have to start counting just after 25. 25 after 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34 and 35. Should I write it here? Yes, I should. Okay. Wants to learn something more? Okay. 22 plus 1. 22 plus 1. This is the blocks of 22. We are going to add more to it. Do you remember what ma'am has told you? Just remember. In past, I told you that when you add number 1 to any of the number, the answer is just the after number of given number. So by adding 1 to 22, which number will we get? What do you say? Is it 23? Yes. By adding 1 to 22, we get number 23. Now look, what is this? 47 plus 10. What is the sum? 47 plus 10. And look, these are the 47 blocks. So what should we do now? We should start counting after number 47. 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56 and 57. 47 plus 10. What should I write? 57? Yes, I should write 57. 33 plus 10. Look, these are 33 blocks. And this is the bunch of 10 blocks. And now what we have to do? We have to count this together. And I told you again, my dear students, whenever you make addition, whenever you want to make oral addition, definitely you have to start just after the given number. So after 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43. Which number I get? I get 43. Okay. Oh, 54 plus 1. These are 54 blocks. I have to add one more to it. What I have just told you, that if I wants to add one more to given number, as a result I will get just after that number 54 plus 1, 55. 17 plus 1. Again, we are going to add one more to the given number. So, what is the after number of 17? Remember it. Okay. After 17, which number will come? 17 and 1? 18. Okay. Oh, look at there. The sum is 69 plus 10. These are 69 blocks. We have to add 10 more to it. So what should we do? We should start counting after 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, and 79. Should I write 79 here? Yes, I should. Okay. Oh, 76 plus 1. What will be the after number of 76? If I want to add one more to 76, which number will I get? I will get number 77. Look, what is this? Look at your hands. Do you have the same fingertips, na? Look, these are called our fingertips. And why I have drawn it here in maths lecture? Think about it. Is it helpful in our lesson? What do you say? I say yes, it is helpful in addition. How it has become helpful in addition? Do you know that? You want to know that? Let me explain. Look at your hands and count with me. Look, this is one fingertip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Look at your hands. We have 15 fingertips in our one hand. As in our other hand, we have the same 15 fingertips. So, you might have a question in your mind, how it has become helpful to us in addition. Look, let me explain. I want to solve this sum. 5 plus 4. Now here I don't have any objects. I don't want to draw any figure. And I want to count. How can I count? Let's see. 5 plus 4. So first of all, count 5 fingertips. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. And we have to add 4 more to it. Okay. So, start counting from here. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Done? Stop there. Now, what exactly we have to do? We have to count all these fingertips together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. What is the answer? 9. Okay? Write it here. This is the way how can we solve the sum. Add the following. How can we make this addition? Look, 4 plus 3. As I told you before, when we are going to make double digit addition, first of all we have to start our counting from ones place always. Okay. We have just seen the figure of our hand. Is it helpful us while doing this sum? Yes. How? Let's see. Our sum is 4 plus 3. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. Stop at 4. 1, 2, 3. Okay? Now count all that fingertips together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Hence we get number 7. Let's write it here. 7. Okay? Now here 1 is alone. No number is there present. Okay? So when there is not any number, what should we do? Yes, we should write the same number. Okay? 26 plus 2. So what should we do? I told you dear again and again that we should start counting from tens place only. Where should we start our counting? We should start our counting from tens ones place only. Okay? So as I just told you, now count your 6 fingertips. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Stop there. Okay? Now count 2 more. 1 and 2. Stop. Now count all that together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. You get number 8. Okay? Now here 2 plus, there not present any number. 2 plus 0. So what should we do? When we add 0 to any of the number or there is not present any number, we should write the same number. By adding 2 to 26, we get number 28. Okay? Understand, my dear students? 2 plus 4. Now count your 2 fingertips. 1 and 2. Now add 4 more to it. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now count it together. What happens? 2 after 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay? 3. Here we don't have any number. So we should write the same number. By adding 4 to number 32, we get number 36. Now we have number 12 plus 3. So first of all, start ones column. 2 plus 3. By adding 3 to 2, start counting after 2, 3, 4 and 5. We get number 5. 1 plus 0, we get number 1. So we can say that 12 plus 3, we get number 15. 43 plus 5. So by adding 5 to number 3, we get number 8. By adding 0 to 4, we get number 4. Add the following. Now what should we do? We have to make oral counting, my dear students. 12 after 13, 14 and 15. We should write 15. This is 52 plus 8. 52 after 53, 54, 55. 56, 57, 58, 59 and 60. We get number 60. Look, my dear students, this was an example. In next lecture, we will make more practice regarding this. Look at there. What is this? These are story sums or word problems. So, you might have heard the stories from your grandma, your mother, your father, elder brothers, sisters. So, do we have to learn story in maths? Is it so? No, my dear students. These are the sums which included a short story forms. Okay? And look, my dear students, this might be helpful in your day-to-day life to solve the day-to-day life problem counting. Okay? So let's see how can we solve the story sums or word problems. Okay? Tom has 3 yellow pencils. How many pencils? Tom has 3 yellow color pencil and 2 red color pencil. How many pencils does he have? Now, he wants to know actually that how many total number of pencil he has. So, what should he do? First of all, he should count his yellow color pencil 1, 2 and 3 and write it in the box. Okay? After that, he has to count the red color pencil which he is having. So, he has 2 red color pencil, 1 and 2. Okay? Now, what he has to do? He has to count all these pencils together. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So, we can say that Tom has 5 pencils. Tom has total 5 pencils with him. There are 4 roses and 2 sunflowers in my garden. How many flowers are there in all? There are 4 roses and 2 sunflowers in my garden. How many flowers are there in all? Now I want to know that if I have 4 rose plants and 2 sunflowers, then total how many plants I have? If I want to say to someone that I have this much of plants in my garden. So if I want to count this together, what should I do, my dear students? First of all, I should write number of roses here. Okay, as I have 4 roses. How many sunflowers do I have? I have 2 sunflowers. I have to write it in this box. Now I want to know together how many flowers I have. So I have to count all these flowers together. 4 after 5 and 6. So I can say that I have 6 flowers together in my garden. Isn't it useful in your daily life? Whenever you are going to shop something in a market and you buy different types of things and you want to know total how many things you have bought or how much should you pay, on that time this type of story sums or word problem becomes helpful to you. Look, 5 boys were playing in the playground. 3 girls also join in. How many kids are there? There were 5 boys already playing and 3 girls comes to join them. Now if I want to know that total how many kids are playing there, what should I do, my dear? First of all, I should write how many boys are present there, which are 5. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay? How many girls are going to join? 3 girls. Look at here, 1, 2 and 3. Means 3 more girls are going to join them. Now if I want to know total how many children or kids are playing there, then what should I do? I should count all these students together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7 and 8. So I can say that there are 8 students playing in that playground. Do you understand? Look, my dear students, in our next lecture I will come with some more addition sums as well as with some more story sums. And now what we are going to learn? As I told you in each and every lecture, dear students, that you have to make practice of tables each and every day. So now we are going to revise the tables. And in next lecture, we will make more practice with interesting examples. This is the table of 1. Now exactly what you have to do, you have to repeat after me. I will take pause after each and every line, okay? And I will wait. You have to speak at your home with me. Huh? One ones are one. Speak up. One twos are two. One threes are three. One fours are four. One fives are five. One sixes are six. One sevens are seven. One eights are eight. One nines are nine. One tens are ten. This is the table of two. Two ones are two. Two twos are four. Two threes are six. Two fours are eight. Two fives are ten. Two sixes are 12. Two sevens are 14. Two eights are 16. Two nines are 18. Two tens are 20. Table of three. Three ones are three. Three twos are six. Three threes are nine. Three fours are 12. Three fives are 15. Three sixes are 18. Three sevens are 21. Three eights are 24. Three nines are 27. Three tens are 30. So this is the quick summary of today's lecture. Today we have learned double digit addition, story sums or word problems, tables 1, 2 and 3. In next lecture, we are going to make more practice regarding this. Okay, are you ready, my dear students? Okay, I will come with some different exercise, new exercise, and we will enjoy to make practice regarding that. Till then, study well. Stay safe, my dear students. Stay happy. Take care, my dear students. And one more thing. Don't trouble your mother. Bye-bye, my dear students.